Are you ready? Are you ready? If you ain't got no money, take your broke ass. Hello, gorgeous people. Love this grab. It's far from Australia. Just have a beautiful Shabby Chic card that I would like to share with you all. I finished this card a couple of nights ago, but just been really busy and haven't been able to share it with you. I do apologize. This particular card was made using this greeting from Miss Anya collection stamp set, and I used this particular image here. So I've stamped her, and then I've colored her, and I've cut her out. So I stamped her onto I don't know what these papers are called, but the lady at the local craft store says these are the ones that you use for stamping, because when you use Copic or stuff like that, it doesn't fluff up the paper. So that's what I have used, but I didn't use any Copic markers, because in Australia here, Copic markers are very expensive, and you buy a set of 72 only. She only has set A or set B, and they retail for $280, and especially Christmas time, I just can't justify spending $280 on Copic markers. It would be great if I got them for a present, but me, myself, just, you know, spending $280 just on colouring is a little bit too expensive at the moment. So maybe I will eventually invest in it one day, but not at this present moment. So that's the image that I used, and to colour her, my shortcut from the Copic markers is this particular watercolor pencils. It's from the Montmartre collection, and it was $19, and it's got 36 colors plus brush in here, and so that's watercolor pencils. These are all the coordinating colors that's available in here, and the colors are just beautiful. And because it's watercolor, you can actually make it darker or lighter by just adding water to it with the paintbrush, but just be very careful. I did find that, because this is like one of the very few times that I have colored with these pencils, that I've learned that not to use too much water, because if you use too much water, even though it's the paper that's designed just for coloring, it still fluffs up a little bit or so, and it makes your paper, like, it rises your paper. It doesn't leave your paper flat. So I had to flatten it once my image has dried with something heavy, and it was flatten it out again. But just be very careful when you're coloring. But this is a cheaper alternative to Copics if you don't want, like, to spend a lot of money with Copics like me. The other goodies that I have used also is this wreath to embellish my card, and it's just absolutely beautiful. I've purchased this from the local thrift store in my old hometown for about $3, and I've used a lot of it already, and that's all that I pretty much have left. I'm so scared to use more of it because I'm loving it so much. The stamp set that I use also is this one here, the Mini Clear Stamp Sets by Cosgrave, and it's this one here, You're the Best. Really good stamp. I've also used this gorgeous peachy lace here also to embellish my card. I've also used this gorgeous mesh fabric, like a curtaining mesh lace, pretty much. And this is what I have also incorporated into my Shabby Chic cushion, if you have guys watched my vids previously. That's what I use for the centerpiece also, and it's absolutely gorgeous. I also use this butterfly punch by EKXSS that I have purchased recently also, and it's a three layering one. It's so absolutely gorgeous. It's my new favorite next to the Monarch butterfly punch by Martha Stewart. So it's really, really gorgeous. It has three butterfly punches that come out, and the first one is like all solid, and then the second one has a few holes, and then the third one has more holes, and a really, really beautiful punch there. And to punch out the butterflies, I use three coordinating color papers. This particular one here is like a silver metallic paper, as you can see there, really, really gorgeous, and that's the punch that I punched out there. And then I also use this creamy pearlized paper here also, as you can see. And then I use this it's like a mulberry paper, it's like a peachy pink color also. Really, really beautiful there. So that's what I also used. And I also used two sizes of doilies, a larger one here and a smaller one. The larger one's from my stash, and the smaller one's given to me in my most recent goodies from Tony, and Tony's YouTube channel is The Tony Kelly. So thank you so much, Tony. I'm so loving this because it goes perfectly with my larger doily, and it's just absolutely beautiful. So thank you for sharing that with me. So they're the doilies that I have used. And I've also used this gorgeous pom-pom trim that I have in my stash, and that's all that I have left of it. It's just absolutely beautiful because I've used it for numerous other projects that I have made in the past also, and it just came out so super cute. So that's what I use. I also use the Flourishes here by Prima, and I use this particular part that's in the corner here, and I just cut that and add it onto my card. It's an older line, say with crystals it says there, but it's actually pearls. It's an older line and it's really, really gorgeous. The paper collection that I have used is by My Mind's Eye, the Lost and Found collection, which is this particular pinky peachy stripe here. And this particular paper is from the Market Street lovely French stripe paper, so the Market Street paper collection. I wish they had like the whole paper stack in my local craft store, but they don't. They only got this particular one as well as another one, which I don't have here to show you guys, but it's the same matching colors. And if you guys want to know what my favorite color is, this is my favorite color. It's absolutely beautiful, like my nails, as you can see. I always paint my nails this color because I'm just loving it. And see, peachy pink, love it too. So that's my favorite color, not just plain pink in general. Peachy pink is beautiful, my favorite color. So if you don't know what peachy pink is, go and find this paper and you will fall in love with it because the colors on here are just heavenly. From there I would like to show you guys my card, and that is my gorgeous card. I'm so super happy with the way that it has turned out, and it's so me. Everything in here speaks VA language pretty much, so it's absolutely gorgeous. I'm loving it, loving this image. So like I mentioned, I stamped it, colored it, cut her out, that's her there, and then I backed her up with pop dots, so she's popped up three-dimensional. So it's the sentiments here, and so are the butterflies here also. Look at the butterflies. So it's got three layers here. It's got the really the peachy pink at the back there, it's got the pearl here, and then it's got the silver on top. And look at that, so beautiful. And that's the flourish there from the Prima stamp that I showed, not the Prima stamp, the Prima bling that I was showing you guys before. And it's this one right here that I cut out, that was just right there in that corner, and just added it here. That's my sentiment from the Kaiser Craft stamp, you're the best there. And that's the little pearl sprays and the beaded spray here from my reef there. And these are my homemade flowers that I just made a couple of nights ago while I was making this card, and just quickly added it on. I actually made the flowers before I made the card, can you believe it? So, and I just worked the card around the actual colors here because they're beautiful, beautiful colors. So these are like a dusky pink satin fabric that I had in my stash. And I've just used some tea dye lace at the back here, did a gathering stitch here also, and they just added a flat back. It's actually not a flat back, it's actually just a normal size pearl in there, and then a string of 3mm pearls on the outside. And here I've just did it like a lollipop flower with some tulle at the back here also, using this particular netting tulle here, or I don't know, mesh, not sure what you call that exactly. And then I've just added a SA Crafter pearl center there, added some random the pearls and the sprays there, my pom-pom tree in the corner here. Behind me I've actually used some white lace at the back here also, but I haven't got that here to show it to you, so I do apologize. And down here it's just like another lollipop flower that I've just laid three with a bit of tulle there, two layers of tulle and two layers of the satin fabric in a creamy color. And the lace that I showed you guys before, which is this one here, is running down the bottom here. And for the background here, I've just cut out this particular circle from this fabric. So to get the circle, I've just used my doily like that, and I just laid it like that, and then I cut like an inch away from it, and then I just frayed the edges. That's what I use for the background. And for the larger size doily here, I've embossed it as well as sprayed it with Lindy Stamp Gang color in the Cocklebell's Coral, and it's just absolutely beautiful. It's like a peachy pink color, it's my favorite. So once I sprayed it and heat dried it, I went over the edges with the Versamark ink, and then I used Nepenthe's crystal embossing powder on it, and it gave it this beautiful, beautiful shine, as you can see there. And then I laid it, I hot glued the three together and then hot glued it onto the background stripes here with the paper. And the paper is actually just cut in half, so I folded the 12 by 12 in half, and then like in half like that, and then I chopped it in half again, so it gives you like a 6 by 6. And I didn't back the inside with anything yet because I'm gonna be keeping this card for myself. I'm so loving the colors, it's so me, like I mentioned, and I probably will make a replica and send it to a gorgeous friend one of these days, but it's just absolutely gorgeous that I just had to keep. So I hope you guys enjoy my card, and hopefully this will inspire you to make a beautiful Shabby Chic card like this also, because I had so much fun and I completed it in a couple of hours and didn't take that long whatsoever. And it's so, so easy and it's so beautiful. The longest part was probably colouring the image, because I pre-coloured the image before I actually made the card, because I knew I was going to be using that image. But the colours just kind of like come together really, really well, and I'm so super happy. So do let me know what you think, and I hope, like I mentioned, it inspires you to make beautiful, beautiful cards like this. And look at all the glitter, it's so me. Oh, I also forgot to mention that I stickled the edges of the flowers here. I've stickled her in random places, as well as add some diamante earrings for her. You can't really see, let me try and see if I can focus closer. Okay, here's a close-up look at her. So for her earrings, she's got little blinging for her earrings there, as you can see there, and I've used it for her her bow in her hair, as well as on her feet there also, as you can see there. Really, really beautiful. So I really like colored it up with all this beautiful glitter. There's a beautiful close-up of the butterfly. Isn't that gorgeous? Layering, three layers, and that's just the paper. And then I've got the peachy pink background that I've stamped and embossed, not stamped, just embossed there. And then the doily from Tony, and I colored her. That's my coloring there. So she's so cute. And there's my stamp set, my flowers, beautiful close-up of my flowers there. And then look at that, isn't that beautiful? And my pom-pom trim, and the layer of the lace at the back there. So that is my beautiful, beautiful, gorgeous card. And let me know what you think. And I hope to see you guys soon with another gorgeous project. All right, do take care. Love you all. Bye. L-A-M-O-R-O-U-S, yeah. G-L-A-M-O-R-O-U-S. We fly in first class, up in the sky. Pop champagne, living my life in the fast lane. I want to change by the glamorous. Oh, flowers, flowers, the glamorous.
Change by the glamorous. Ooh, flowers, flowers, the glamorous.